Oh, yeah. Oh no! Rapide. Oh.
Il va trop savoir que je vais faire. Il va trop savoir que je vais faire. Puis je vais savoir qu'est-ce qu'il fait. Je disais ça de même, mais je sais que c'est impossible. Mais c'est sûr que j'aimerais ça, mais c'est impossible. Okay. Non, mais je sais, mais ce que tu veux dire par là, qu'est-ce que Nick veut, puis qu'est-ce que tu es prêt à donner, puis ce que lui veut. Mais non, mais en principe, il va seulement demander. Il va seulement demander à la Lune, ben, pas la Lune, mais tu sais, il va seulement demander assez haut.
Oh, good try there, bud.
Non, c'est sûr. Oh, ben non, toi! Hostie, G-Man, va te cacher, hostie! Ah, ok. Ah, ok. Hostie Magic, mon hostie de lettre, au collier. Hostie, les chances qu'il line, ton minime, il l'a eu, hostie. Hostie, Christ de mauvais. Ouais, c'est ça. En est-ce, ouais. Putain, là, j'ai dit, j'allais y aller, tu vois.
Oh, good try there, bud!
Oh. Mais ça, ouais. Tu le fais à plusieurs fois, pis oups, c'est un coup, tu le vois. À 8-0, il n'a plus de game. Ok, ouais. Ouais, ça c'est peut-être une autre histoire. Ah, tu peux. Non.
Hey, bon boy. Ça là.
Ah, mais ça m'a déjà élevé. Ah, hein. Ah, pour ça m'a élevé ça en overtime en plus. Je me demandais, ce que je fais. Bambi's a été ajouté au groupe de Sudbury. Mais dans un centre. Fait que dans un sens, il peut pas le signer, Bambi, c'est ça? Non. Ok. Ici. Ah, ok. Je sais que la Marvel est en recrutement parce que l'administration est débarquée. Et ton player? Oh, maintenant, ok, d'abord, tu dois connaître tantôt peut-être sa game. Ah, ok. Ah, ouais. Non, ouais. Ouais, c'est ça, exact. Ben oui, exact. Ouais, il t'avait fait là. Parce que moi. Ah non, mais ça c'est sûr. Genre.
There you go. Oh oui. Oh ben non.
Je t'assure que tu apportes pas la visite, ben non, c'est ça. Elle est venue sur le poteau extérieur. Oh! Ok.
C'est pas compliqué, Price, ça te prend au moins une fois savoir que je le fais, que je fais ça.
Ouais. Patine, si tu veux jouer! Match des Blue Jays.
On est dans la défense. On la bloque là. Ton cœur. C'est bien fort. Moi je suis bloqué derrière la vue, moi. Je suis dans le vue. Si je peux pas l'enlever. Tiens. Ouf.
Oh, good try there, bud.
Let's go, Price.
Oh, non.
Fais ta job, là. Fais ta job, la lumière.
Oh, j'ai scoré pareil.
Ah oui, sacrément. Ben. Non, c'est violent. Ah non, tu veux, t'as pas de stress. Il jouait dans quoi? Huh? Ah non, mais c'est une question de même. Ah, c'est good. Thanks. Fait que je vais vous laisser les enfants. C'est pas ça que je vais faire. Je sais pas. Je vais vous laisser, mes enfants.
Ok, grand-papa B.
Ouais, c'est ça. Ok, bye. Un seul mec ou non? Peut-être un mec pour vous. Je sais pas. J'ai pas envie de vivre la même histoire.
The gauntlet's been dropped and the puck's about to be. James Cebulski and Ray Ferraro, let's get it on here for this EASHL Challenge.
Mais le goaler, il est bon. C'est prof.
Both teams are lined up and we are set to get things going. The Sea Dogs take possession here on the opening draw and we are underway. Moves it to Huberdeau. From the left side, it moves to the middle of the ice. Tri-Cities got it across the line. Here's an offensive chance. Smart heads up play to neutralize the threat. Here's a rocket of a shot. Denies him on the slapper. Here's a short pass to Francis. Grabs the puck at center. Nice zone entry from the right side. Tri-Cities got the puck in the corner. And they can't connect. He almost lost it for a second there, but regains control of the puck. Right up the gut into the attacking zone. Moves it quickly over to Lindstrom. And that's picked off in front. Pokes it away to stay on the attack. Oh, and he tracks it perfectly in the offensive end. Oh, he had that corner, but he puts it off the outside of the post.
What a shot. I mean, really good play, but it hits the post and like it...
Oh. Scores! What a beauty!
Oh, the goaltender's tracking this well, James, till it hits the defender's stick. It changes the arc. He can't get to it. It's in the net.
Tri-Cities got the game's first goal as they lead here 1-0 early in the first.
Always awesome to be in front of the game. You push the pace. You make the other team uncomfortable when you're out front.
Quick feed to Lindstrom. And now he moves it quickly to Paul. Here's a chance. And now it's grabbed by Huberdeau. And that goes off a player in front. Tri-Cities got the puck in their own end. St. John's got a hold of it against the wall. Passes it over to Paul. Oh, he'd like to have that pass back. Lindstrom's got it in the offensive zone. Move to the middle. Stopped by the goaltender. Moves with the puck at the corner. Just wide. Tri-Cities got the puck along the wall. Can't connect. Feeds it on over to Lindstrom. Couldn't connect on that pass. Quick pass to Huberdeau. St. John's got the puck in the defensive end. Passes it to Paul. The Sea Dogs carry it along the wall. Unable to reach that one. Takes the shot and he makes the save. Receives the pass. Scores!
Well, you just keep working away. Your lines roll over and over and over. You hope to build a little momentum. One shot ties the game. And now it's a whole new ball game.
And we are all evened up here. Past the midway mark of the frame. You can feel the energy in this crowd. It's a tie game. Grabs the puck here in the neutral zone.
Assisted by number 53 and by number 5. Time of the goal.
Taken by Lindstrom. Tri-Cities got the puck. Passes over to Uncle Larry. Hammers a shot! Airmails it!
Did he ever? He's got to bring that down a couple of feet.
Play set to resume with the faceoff ready to go. St. John's got a hold of the puck.
I'm the
boss!
He'll
feel that one. Picked up along the boards by Paul. Now a quick pass to Lindstrom. Couldn't complete the play. St. John's got it now. Oh, it comes up with nothing on the play.
Just misses the net, but really the scoring chance is not dangerous if you can't get the puck at the goaltender.
Getting into the later stages of this period, we are all tied up in this one. Puck is dropped and he wins the draw here in the defensive zone. Jagr's taking it from his own end.
moves it to Lack, and it's a quick pass to Uncle Larry. Takes the pass across the line from center.
With possession on the pass,
taken along the wall by Huberdeau. Right up front, just a simple save by Fleury. Play resumes as they win the draw here inside the offensive zone. Tri-Cities got control of it now from their own end. Slides it across. Puck scooped up by Marowa. And now it's grabbed by Huberdeau. Here's a short pass to Lindstrom. And that pass goes awry. Keeler's got it now deep inside his own end. Fails to find the open man. Nice dish from the left wing. Huge steal in his own end. Horn sounds, bringing an end to what has been a pretty fun start to this one.
Hey, Martin, c'est ton ami. Le magicien.
Two more periods still to come. We'll be right back with much more action here on EA Sports. Well, the first 20 is in the books. Let's see what this second period offers. Period number two now underway. Let's see what this one has in store for us. One period already in the books. Ray, how have you seen this thing?
The Americans burnt the puck up constantly in that first period. Probably pretty lucky the game's tied. James, when you look forward to the rest of this game, they have to do a much better job when they have the puck to make sure they keep it.
St. John's looking to break out of their own end. Here's a pass down low. And that's just out of reach. Huge play in his own end to come up with the puck. Not able to connect. Huberdeau's got it along the wing. Moves it quickly over to Marowa. And he gets a paddle on that one.
This is a quality chance that the goaltender turns aside right from the slot.
And that one's broken up. Gets it over to Uncle Larry. Here's an odd man rush. Sends it over. Takes the feed. Quick feed down low. And he regains control of the puck. St. John's got a hold of it along the wall. He's got a step. Big time stop on the break.
Goalie came out, matched the shooter's speed, and shut down the chance.
Moves the puck. Quick feed to Lindstrom. He might have a step here. Drives to the paint. Misses the net.
Yeah, he's trying to be too perfect here. He's looking to place this puck into one small area, but he misses the net.
That pass doesn't go. Feeds the puck up to Uncle Larry. Couldn't catch up to that pass. Dishes it to Marowa. Through the neutral zone, moving the puck along the side. Into the attacking area from the left side. That's off a stick. St. John's got the puck inside the defensive zone. Tries to get it to Huberdeau. Nice block. Lack's got the puck now here inside his own defensive zone. And the linesman calls icing on the play. Nearing the midway mark of the period. It's all tied up. Huberdeau's won the draw here in the offensive zone.
Hey, maybe you can create some offense against the tired team after the icing.
And he slides it quickly to Lindstrom. Great defensive effort breaking up the pass.
side.
In front. He gets a piece of it with a stick.
I like how he was able to follow the puck. Good save in close.
Tosses it on to Marowa. Picked off. Tried to be too cute on the pass. Jabs the puck away. St. John's. Oh, he put it just wide as it hits the outside of the post.
St. John's got to feel a little unlucky here. Off the post, and the game's still tied.
And tries to make a diagonal pass to Keeler. Hammers the shot. Scores! The go-ahead goal!
This game has been tight. Now somebody's got a leg up. Oh, he tries the windmill glove save here, but there's so much traffic. I don't know that he really had a look at it. He's trying to catch it, and he missed it.
Francis wins it. They gain possession here inside the neutral zone. And now it's over to Uncle Larry. Pass right on the doorstep. Up the skate and score!
You can have it bounce off your skate, James, but look at that. They've waved this off. This looks like a kicking motion is ruled by the referee. Francis doesn't get a very good break here. This puck hits his foot, and the officials have ruled, as we see, that it's no goal because of a distinct kicking motion.
And the video replay officials will now decide the fate of this goal. Centering pass! Picked up along the wall by Paul. Quick pass to Marowa. Oh, what a save in front!
Fleury's right on top of that chance. Great A spot, great A save.
There's the whistle. Offside is the call. Late goings of this period. Tri-Cities trailing by one. Puck is dropped and we are back underway. Pass to Keeler. And they fail to go tape to tape. Sends it quickly to Uncle Larry. Tri-Cities got the puck in their own end. Sends the pass down low. Breaks up the pass in the defensive zone. Jostles the puck loose. Couldn't find the intended target. Slides the puck over. Tosses it to Francis. There's the whistle from the linesman calling it offside. St. John's generated a lot of quality scoring chances, which is why they lead here late in the second. The Americans win it. Here's a chance to make something happen inside the neutral zone. And down he goes as the puck goes free. Tri-Cities gain possession. Takes control of the puck. Grabbed along the boards by Lemieux. Tri-Cities on the attack.
1 minute left in the second.
Under
period.
A minute to go here inside the second period. And they can't convert on the play. That opportunity is rejected. Tri-Cities got the puck along the boards. Now over to Uncle Larry. Both teams have gotten on the board, and this one has been pretty much a dogfight through the first 40 minutes as the period comes to an end. Sabolski, Ray Ferraro ready to bring you all the action. Period number three is set to get underway. And play resumes as the puck is dropped. Grabs it at his own end. And he slides it quickly to Uncle Larry. And the long-range shot goes off target. An attempt to clear the puck from deep inside his own end. And we've got a two-on-one. Big-time stop.
Had to be sharp. That's a great A chance.
Blast from the blue line. Tremendous stop by Fleury. St. John's done a wonderful job putting a lot of pucks on net, and they lead it early in this third period. The frozen biscuits dropped, and we are back underway here. From his own end, he picks up the puck. Looking to make something happen in the offensive zone. And the shot dies in the traffic jam. Moves it up through the middle from the right. Maintains possession. Picks off the feed. Look out, a two-on-one. Handles it along the blue line. Way off target. Pass right in front. Can't connect. Slides the puck to Lidstrom. Gains the zone on the left wing. To his teammate. Scores. Three is the magic number.
Man, that goalie is getting just torched down there. Three in a row here. I'm loving the way they attacked on this rush here, James. Once they realized they had the extra man, they moved the puck quickly, and the defenders just can't keep up.
Still lots of time left in the period. St. John's got a two-goal lead. They'd love to build on it. Puts it to the front of the net. Deflected away. Nice defensive use of the stick there. Here's a shot. Too much traffic in the lane. Moves it to Huberdeau. Offside is the call, and we'll have a face-off just outside the offensive zone. St. John's attempt to put more pucks on net has paid off as they lead it in the third. Francis wins it in the dots. Tries to get it over to Lemieux and couldn't find the intended receiver on that one. And a nice poke check inside the neutral zone. Here's a short pass to Huberdeau. Tries to the crease. Scores!
You get one, you get hungry for a second one. Even if you're not a goal scorer, you get that early. Now you want to hunt for a second goal.
Makes it a double on the play.
When you get into this position, that puck's got to be off your stick in a hurry. You don't have much time to think about it.
Nice job tying up his opponent. The blocker saved by Fleury. Moves it quickly over to Francis. At center ice now, he grabs the puck. Quick feed to Marowa. They've got numbers. And the puck departs the zone. Dished on over to Keeler. Jocelyn for the puck and it's knocked away. Puts it in deep. Moves it on over to Marowa. Takes the feed. Puck knocked loose in the neutral zone. Good heads up play to knock it away. Tri-City's got the puck. Feeds it over to Lemieux. Oh, and a good heads-up defensive play. Takes the pass from the left wing.
Huberdeau's in on the action, too. He's got a goal already as they run away with this one.
Tri-Cities on the attack. Offside the call, and we'll have a face-off just outside the blue line. St. John's showing no signs of slowing down here in this third period, up big time. Francis wins it in the neutral zone. Puck picked up in the open ice. St. John's gained possession along the boards. Stretches one out to Huberdeau. Can't get a hold of that pass. There's the whistle, icing the call. Past the halfway mark of this period, the Sea Dogs have taken control of this one, now leading by three. Francis has won the draw. Lax lugging the puck. Lemieux got it across the line. Pad seat. He scores! It looked like he had made the save, but that's in the back of the net for a goal.
I always thought playing goal was tough. Now you got to stop your own guys, too.
Tri-City's still got to find two more goals, but they at least have one back.
That gives them a little bit of hope, and the bench seems to have come alive a little bit.
They take possession as he locks them up off the faceoff. Right out in front, and they can't connect. Puck knocked loose after that hit. From the left side, they gain the zone. Sends it across, and it totally whiffs on it. Jagr's got it against the boards. Couldn't make that one happen. Goaltender gave up nothing as it hits the outside of the post and will play on.
Tri-City's close, but they can't get close enough. That shot hits the goalpost and stays out.
Fleury's going to hang on for a whistle here in the third.
Well, there's not much time left here as you get into the final 20 minutes. The game's close. A mistake now would be critical.
The Sea Dogs have been the busier team in the shot department, and they lead it late in this third period. And the puck leaves the zone going back to center ice. Quick pass to Paul. Couldn't complete the play. Slides it to Paul. Nothing doing on that. Play whistle dead because of an offside. Here in the later stages of this period, Tri-City's still behind the eight balls. They trail by two goals. Johns won the draw in the neutral zone. Steps across the blue line.
On the box.
Way too much congestion blocks that. Moves behind the net. Takes a bump but still hangs on to the puck.
In the third period.
Inside of the final minute here in the third. Handles the puck. Uncle Larry's got it deep in the offensive end. Stays with it. And that's out of reach and out of the offensive zone. Feeds the puck over to Uncle Larry. All alone!
Oh, he didn't have enough gas to get the shot off. Really good work by the defender to close the gap.
Scoops up the puck now. Nice feed from the right wing. Quick feed down low. Aaron pass and the play's broken up. Moves inside! Keeler's caught with this stick and the officials are signaling for a hooking penalty. And there's the whistle stopping the play. And the officials signaling for hooking on the play.
You gotta move your feet here. You're chasing the play. As soon as you stop your feet, you're gonna get called.
The Sea Dogs will have a chance to get on the power play for the first time this evening. Francis has it in their own end. They'll want to clear the zone here while they're trying to kill off this penalty. Gets it out of his own end. There's the whistle stopping the play. Look at this, pushing and shoving.
Yeah, it got heated up pretty quickly.
Great read by the winger to take possession with the two centermen tied up. Big time defensive play. That's all she wrote from this one tonight. Well, and as we put a bow on this one, they called upon the Thunder, and they got it, literally, here.
Well, man, James, they challenged these guys to a match. It didn't work out anyway the way they thought it was going to, and they take the L.
Fall down, we'll work on. monsters into the ground. One by one, the clock strikes 12. We punch back in inside our shells.
Position for this challenge. Let's find out who gets the bragging rights in this one. Both teams seem ready, and they are about to drop the puck on this opening faceoff. The Americans start with possession as we are now underway. Puck moved over to Lemieux. Takes a shot. That goes off a twig. Settles things down and gets control of it once again. Tipped in front. Great save by the goaltender to get a pad on that one. Keeping the puck out of the net. We're still in the early stages of this period. We're still scoreless. Tri-City's got it, and they're on the attack. Couldn't connect, although not exactly an ideal pass to begin with. Centering pass! The Pats take possession in the defensive end. Can't catch up to the pass. Moves the puck over to Mitchell. Taken by Lemieux. Tri-City's got the puck along the wall. Makes the save as he gets a piece of it with the glove.
David's athleticism serves him well there. Excellent stop.
And he takes a shot. Oh, what an effort giving up the body there. And that one's picked off in the neutral zone. Huge steal in his own end. Takes the pass and works the cycle down low. Denied by the goaltender. Icing is called, stopping the play dead. Inching closer to the midway mark of the period. We've still got zeros on the board. Tri-Cities won the draw.
You don't spend much time in your zone if you can win the draw like that.
The Pats gain control of the puck against the wall. Tri-Cities looking to break out of their own end. That pass goes a little sideways. Tries to go off the wall, and it's broken up.
Yeah, I think he thought there was more room there, bounced it, and didn't get it back to himself.
Big time hit against the boards. Tell me this, what would you rather take, against the wall or against the open ice?
Oh, no, I want it up against the wall, but you got to get close. If you're a foot or two away, you bounce like a basketball.
Big collision. On the redirect, the Americans scoop it up along the boards. Working the puck deep inside their own end. Can't find his man. Tri-City's got possession here in the neutral zone. Manages to hang on. Moves the puck down low. And now he moves it to Lack. There's the whistle. Offside is the call. Stopping the play. More than half the period has expired. The game is still scoreless. Regina's won it. Moves it over to Breezy. Finds some space in the corner. Moves the puck to Lemieux. And now he angles it across to Uncle Larry. Feeds it down low. Huge play in his own end to come up with the puck. Moves it to Breezy. And that skips away on a nice defensive deflection. Looking to make something happen along the boards. Regina's grabbed a hold of the puck. Here's a shot! Just wide of the net. Grigorenko's going to play it near the point. Puts it on goal. And that goes off a player. Tri-City's got a hold of it against the wall. Sends the pass over. Here's a short pass to Uncle Larry.
Keep
from
your
the
head
neutral
up,
zone now. Moves it over to Mitchell. No one home on that play. The Americans get a hold of the puck along the boards. And now he moves it quickly to Lemieux. Cutting to the slot. Great read on the block. Oh, he'd like to have that pass back. And the linesman calls icing on the play. Just here in the late stages of this frame. Still scoreless in this one. Slides in off the wing after the centerman tied him up. Passes right to the front, and they can't convert on the play. Brings the puck into the offensive end now. What a steal in his own end. Moves the puck along the half wall.
That was coconuts.
And that's blocked.
Black's looking around for somebody to fight. He's going to have to go and fill the dance card somewhere else. He took a pretty good jolt there, James, and I think we should take another look. He seems a little shaken up.
The setters will glide into the dot. While the setters are jammed up, nice job by the winger to steal the puck. There's the whistle. Offside is the call. Face-off here in the neutral zone, and we are back underway. Now a quick pass to Morris. Moves right to the middle. Oh, they telegraphed the pass, and he picks it off. Moves it quickly over to Mitchell. Can't connect. Intercepts it in the neutral zone. Poked away. Quick feed to Mitchell. Couldn't connect on that pass. There's the horn bringing period number one to an end. Still no score in this one. Both teams are back at center ice, and we are ready to get period number two underway. Still no score in this one. We'll see if period number two finds ourselves a goal. Ray, what's your assessment of the game to this point?
Tri-City's focus with the puck has to be a heck of a lot better than it was in that first period. Man, they were a turnover machine in this scoreless game.
Slides it across to Uncle Larry. Gains the zone from the right. Lemieux's going to play it against the half wall. And he comes up with it. Regina's regained possession of the puck. dishes it to Morris. The Pats take it along the wall. And that's picked off. Big play inside the defensive zone. Tri-Cities looking to break out. Quick pass to Francis. Couldn't complete the play. And uses the length of his stick to knock that puck away. And now he tries to get it across to Uncle Larry. And that pass goes awry. Breezy's gaining momentum. And he uses his reach to disrupt the play. Regina's got the puck along the boards. Kind of lost control for a second there, but regains possession. Nice pass. Rocked him in the open ice. Oh, tried to pick his corner and puts it off the outside of the post. Oh, what a blocker stop by Fleury. Uncle Larry's got it in the defensive end. Smart heads up play to intercept the pass. Tri-Cities carrying the puck deep inside their own zone. From one point man to another. Dismissed that chance. Gets the full use of his stick on the poke check. Fails to find the open man. There's the whistle from the linesman calling an offside. Still lots of time left here in this frame. Still looking for our first goal. Regina's got a hold of the puck off the draw. Quick stop by Fleury.
Make the save, help yourself out at the same time. Good stop, but the better part is that he gets the puck away from the front of the net.
Zero fear on this guy's part as he blocks it. He grabs the puck here at the point. Tri-Cities ready to go on the attack. Steps into all of that. Moves it to Mitchell. They've got the defense outnumbered. Grigorenko's taken down to the ice. We got a penalty coming up. And here comes the judgment from the official. Lax called for tripping. He's off to the box. Played with fire. He got burned, Ray.
He's digging around for the puck, and sometimes you just get caught. This time the player goes down, and he's got to go to the box.
Tri-Cities penalty killers get a hold of it. They get it out of the defensive end. Looking to break out here on the power play. Regina's in now, and a poke check knocks the puck away. Tri-Cities got a hold of it along the wall. Puck is cleared out of the defensive zone. Breezy's got it now deep inside his own end.
Man, they're back in their own zone again on the power play. They've got to be a little more urgent getting the puck up the ice and into the zone. They don't even have a shot on net on this power play.
Moved into the middle. Here's a short pass to Mitchell. Deep inside the defensive end, still trying to clear. Regina's got the puck. Still tied here as the power play fails to come up with a goal.
That power play was a lot of window dressing. They had the puck in the offensive zone, but really didn't generate a whole lot. The penalty killers must be pretty happy with that.
Morris plays it now and tries to make a diagonal pass to Breezy. From the point, looks to make something happen. And that slides right out to center ice. Lax got it in the defensive zone. Gaining momentum up along the side. Regina's got it in the neutral zone. Breakaway! Denies him with a big-time save!
He thought he had him beat, but the goalie gets over to make a great stop.
The Americans have it against the wall. Oh, and they go back on offense! Works it across to Mitchell. Not able to connect. And it's a quick pass to Breezy. Almost lost the puck, but hangs on here as play continues. Pass across to Lemieux. Sends it out right in front, and that one's turned away. Huge steal in his own end. Tri-Cities got the puck here in the open ice. Picks off the pass. Grigorenko's been brought down, and we're going to get a penalty here. There's the stoppage of play. Let's see what the officials say. Caught him just as he was picking up speed, and he's going to pay for it with the trip.
Oh, you're spinning with him. You're trying to get your stick into the puck lane, and you end up tripping him up.
Back to the face-off circle. Regina's won the draw. Puck picked up by Lyubushkin. He scores!
A finish late in the period seems to carry over into the next period more often than not. What a great time to score.
Regina's got the lead here late in the second. Give me the strategy here now, coach.
It's not to sit back on your heels. It's to get up and attack. Try and stretch this lead out while you have your opponent reeling.
Takes the shot. Oh, what a save by Fleury. And he coughs it up with the pass.
Regina's turned this game into a really tight affair because nobody can move the puck very freely with good stick positioning to intercept pucks.
Just around the corner, Ray and I'll bring you all the action in a moment. Welcome back, everyone. Both teams lined up at center ice, and we are ready to get this third period underway. Puck is dropped, and play resumes. Parisi's got it along the boards. Oh, what a stop by Fleury. Moves it quickly over to Lack. Keeps hold of the puck. And now it's over to Lemieux. Into the attacking end. Levels them with the hit. The Pats have it from their own end. Some great thievery in the open ice. Regina's got a hold of it against the wall. Sends a pass over. Here he is on the backhand. Blocked in front. Scooped up along the wall by Lemieux. The Americans get a hold of the puck along the boards. Exploring options here inside the defensive zone. Quick feed to Lemieux. And the officials are calling a delayed penalty here. Looks like a trip. And let's see what the call is. Parisi's going to the box for tripping.
Fishing around for the puck. He gets a stick into the player's feet. And this becomes an easy call.
Well, as both teams dig in for the faceoff here just moments away, it's our first opportunity to look at the power play unit here.
There have been times over the last couple of weeks where this power play looks great. Other times, not so good. But this is a key moment in this game. A chance to tie it up with the man advantage.
And sends it just out of reach. Can't connect. Tri-Cities gain possession along the boards. The Pats will play it in their own end. And they get the puck out of harm's way. From their own end, trying to kickstart this power play. Tri-Cities got it along the wall. Francis plays the puck. And that one's broken up by a great defensive play. And the puck is moved to a safer spot on the ice. The Americans gain possession along the wall. And that's broken up with a stick in front. Regina's lead is still intact after a solid effort by the penalty killing unit.
Well, that's a missed opportunity, isn't it? A chance to tie. They don't cash in, and now we're back to 5-on-5.
Right in the slot, and that one's broken up. There he is, he's got a step. Great save!
Oh, I thought he was going to beat him, but the goalie comes up large.
We haven't even hit the midway mark of the period. Regina's ahead 1-0. Well, that's one way to win the draw as he skates away with the puck after the two centers were tied up. Denies him again! Fleury's got the puck. Boy, he's been under fire tonight.
Been really sharp, and in a close game, you can't make a mistake that costs a critical goal.
Regina's got the edge in the shot department, a big reason why they lead here in this third period. Puck grab by Mitchell. Can't connect! And the goaltender grabs that one for a whistle to try to slow things down here. The centermen glide into position. Francis wins it in the offensive zone. And it comes up with the save! solid hit on the play, and that knocks the puck off his stick. That's just a great heads-up read at center ice. Big-time stop there. Regina's got the puck along the wall. Slides the pass over to Mitchell. From the boards, he takes that pass. With the stop. Unloads from the blue line. Again, the denial by the goaltender.
Fleury's been a leader tonight. You don't need a speech. You need to play well. He's done that tonight, and he's kept his team right in it.
Past the midway mark of the frame, James and Ray with you tonight. 1-0 is where we sit at this point. Sneaks away with the puck after he was tangled up on the draw. Tri-City's got control of it now from their own end. Grigorenko's been whacked on the play. The official's arm is up in the air. Time for the official to pass down his sentence. You call that a hatchet job with that slash?
I call that chopping broccoli right there.
Very good reference. The Pats send their man advantage unit out once more.
Time to get back to work on a power play that's already scored tonight. Don't change much. Keep working away in the same manner.
And the puck skips out of the zone. They'll have to regroup. That pass doesn't go. Puck scooped up by Mitchell. Keeps a hold of it on the play. Grabs the puck and looks to make something happen. And they manage to clear it. The Pats gain control of the puck against the wall. There's the whistle, and this power play will come to an end as another man's off to the box. Breezy's going off for interference.
Like every player in the history of the game, he doesn't like the call, but he's going to have to go serve his minor penalty.
Puck set to drop. We've got some four-on-four coming up.
I think the best strategy is to be aggressive on the four-on-four. Don't wait for the other guys to make a mistake.
Steps up with the block, and that shot dies in traffic. Offside is the call. Wow, completely ignored the whistle there. Regina's attempt to put more pucks on net has paid off as they lead it in the third. Morris has won the draw here in the neutral zone. And they'll dump it in. Tri-City's got the puck along the boards. Nice zone entry on the left side. Offside the call, and we'll have a face-off just outside the blue line. Past the halfway mark of this period, Regina's up 1-0. And play resumes as the puck is dropped. We got a delayed penalty coming up here as the ref's hand goes up in the air. And the play is whistled dead. Let's see what the call is coming up. The Pats have been handed two for interference.
Once he puts up his little token argument here, he's going to circle around a bit and try and regroup here as he goes to the penalty
box. Were you a haggler?
Always. You never think it's the right call.
And the puck leaves the zone. Trying to get something going here with this man advantage as they start from their own end. Receives the pass. Takes the shot. Oh, he stops him with the glove. Great reflexes there. Regina's offense, the story tonight as they lead it here in this third period. Morris wins the draw on their own end. And they get some breathing room as the puck leaves the defensive end. Tri-City's got a hold of it along the wall. Takes the pass. A chance to get it out of the defensive zone. And that's a big clear on that play.
Yeah, coaches are always telling us about details. There's one of them. Get the puck out late in a game.
With authority. The Americans get a hold of the puck in their own end. Regina's back to even strength. Huge effort by their penalty-killing unit.
Sometimes a power play is more critical than others. Lots of pressure on that five-man group. They didn't get it done, though. They missed at a really important time.
Grabs the puck at center. Takes the feed. Quick pass to Lyubushkin. Slides the puck down low. Moved out in front, and they can't connect. The Pats have it against the wall. Nice defensive robbery on that. Referee's hand goes up in the air. We got a delayed penalty coming up here. And he denied that opportunity. And the puck stopper tags his man to get the extra attacker on the ice. Moves it to Morris. And there's the whistle. Let's get the call. special here. Lemieux going off to the box for 2 minutes.
Like every player in the history of the game, he doesn't like the call, but he's going to have to go serve his minor penalty.
The Pats once again send out their power play unit, and what a golden opportunity here. Regina's got it in the offensive zone. Right to the middle, and that one's blocked. Tri-Cities penalty killers get a hold of it. Here's a clearing attempt from their own end, and he's able to move the puck across the blue line and out of harm's way. Play whistled dead because of an offside. Regina's not far from the finish line here as they lead it late in this third. Francis wins it in the neutral zone. More time off the clock as they grab the puck. And they fail to go tape to tape. Here they come, three of them. Stopped by the goaltender. Fleury's got the puck. And
hey, that means the play's supposed to end here. They're still pushing around pretty good.
Officials getting ready to drop the puck. Puck possession so key in today's game. Center's jammed up and the winger grabs the puck. And he rings the post.
Mitchell's been so dangerous offensively tonight, but he can't get a bounce. That puck is off the post and out again.
There's the final horn, and this one's in the books. Well, they felt like they were ready for prime time, and I guess they were proven wrong.
Yeah, time to go back to the drawing board. Challenge somebody else next time.
Maybe turn that controller upside down, right?
The rich get richer.
time to find out who gets to own this one. Two teams looking start for a win, and we are set to go. The Phoenix have established possession here early in this one as they win the draw. And now he moves it to Sedin. Enters the offensive zone from the left. Fragapani's got the puck, and they'll be forced to tag up after that missed pass. Picks up the puck in his own end. Takes the feed. And that puck leaves the zone. Sends the pass over. Here's a short pass to Johns. The Americans scoop it up along the boards. Tri-City's got a hold of the puck. And now he angles it across to Anthony. There's the whistle. Offside is the call, stopping the play. Still plenty of time left in this frame. We've still got zeros on the board. This neutral zone face-off set to go, and we are back underway. Moves the puck. He scores!
Well, I don't think anybody's really settled into the game yet, and already we have the game's first goal.
Sherbrooke's got that lead. They were talking about wanting to quiet that home crowd here.
Well, they certainly did. Out of the gate quickly, a couple of shifts, now they're up 1-0.
Scored by number 97.
Grabs the puck in the defensive zone. Over the line they come. Nice defensive robbery with the stick. Quick pass over to Sedin. Great feed from the left side. Here's a shot. Gets a piece of it with the blocker.
Fleury's helping out everybody here. The defense doesn't have to worry about the front of the net anymore. The puck's in the corner.
On the doorstep. Oh, caught him with his head down. Slides the puck over. And he slides it quickly to Sedin. The Americans take possession in the defensive end. Here they are on the attack. Slides it across. Stones him in front. And a penalty coming up as the official blows the play dead. And he's going off. Interference, the call, Ray.
Looks like a pretty easy call to make as he completely cuts off the lane for the player to skate through.
Off his stick. Long jam in front. That's broken up. Nice zone entry from the middle. Stops it with a glove. AJ simply going to slow it down here. Ray, do you like the strategy?
I do, but he hasn't touched the puck much this period, James, so you get to handle it a little bit here and maybe a little nervous, so you jump on it and get to reset.
Sherbrooke's won the draw. Couldn't find the intended target. Handles the puck. Back at the point, they set it up. Steps in front of the shot. He almost lost it for a second there, but regains control of the puck. Sends it in on the attack. The Americans gain possession in their own end. Pushes it across to Lemieux. Can't hang on to the puck after the play. And now it's grabbed by Lemieux. Turned that one aside. And they can't score on the power play. They still trail by a goal.
Well, there are times you look for your power play, at the very least, to gain a little momentum. They needed a goal. Now they still trail by one back to even strength.
Past the midway mark in this period, we've got a 1-0 hockey game thus far. Grabs the puck here inside the offensive end. Anthony's working it around in the corner. And couldn't find the intended receiver on that one. Centered out in front, and that's blocked. Great defensive play to break it up. Sherbrooke's looking to break out of their own end. Knocked away. And that one's broken up by a great defensive play. Gets control of the puck here in his own end. Tri-City's moving it along the wing. And now he tries to get it across to Lack. Oh, and that backfires.
Yeah, he tried to bounce pass to himself. Didn't work.
Puck sent over to Johns. Tries to feed it across. On the attack along the boards. Play is blown dead. We've got a penalty on the way. tripping the call here.
Always makes me crack up since I've retired and how guys argue about penalties that are so obvious.
2 minutes is 2 minutes, and off to the box he goes to think about it. Hangs onto the puck. Tri-City's got control of it now from their own end. Here he is from the slot, and that carries off a stick. Nice pass. Blocked in traffic. Here's the chance to set up now. Picks off the pass. Right in front of the official's eyes, and the hand is in the air. Grabs the puck here in the neutral zone. From the point, they take control of it. Quick snap! It's in the back of the net, and they score!
Doesn't take them very long either. With the delayed penalty, they're able to score. It nullifies their power play, but it doesn't really matter.
Supposed to, yeah, I recall. Sorry, babe, I just got the call. It turns my stomach to disappoint you. I know the trouble that you must go to. It's from a place you can barely imagine.
good. That's great.
C'est fini?
Ouais, je pense que c'est fini.